In this video, we'll take a quick look at how you can make such a low-poly character. This is Bart Simpson. In the last video, many have guessed him correctly. I will also show you what its texture looks like. It is very basic, so anyone can draw it. Let's start with the character's head. In Bart's case, the ideal primitive is a cylinder, so let's add it to the scene. Reduce the number of polygons in the box below. Here we have the head, neck and upper body. Everything is made from the same cylinder primitives. I've used more of them for the arms and legs, while a sphere is a good fit for the belly. Now it remains to take care of the details. Let's start with the head. For the eyes, I've used two spheres. The nose is made of a cube, so are the ears of the character. I've combined the neck with the head and added a few more polygons there, and for the lower lip. Here's how an updated version of the head looks. Let's edit everything else. Here are the clothes, shorts and a t-shirt, and sneakers with socks. For the hands, I've used two cylinders, and they have turned out looking like very simple fists. And that's all! The character is ready for texturing. In the UV editing tab, I select all the polygons of the model and use the unwrap command. The location of the resulted unwrap doesn't really matter, since I will move parts of it or the corresponding colors of the texture by hand. You'll see what I mean in just a moment. In the Texture Paint tab, I'll create a 128x128 pixels texture. Here is the result. This square is used for the ears, the white circle is the emblem on the sneakers, and the black one is the character's eye pupils. The rest is the colors of clothing and skin. The two triangles on the side are Bart's hair. Here's a closer view of it. As you can see, there's nothing complicated. In the next video, we'll take a look at another low-poly character with a more interesting hand-painted texture. Thank you for watching!